The hotel industry is one of the hardest hit sectors amid the COVID-19 outbreak. If and when government allows hotels to resume normal operations, customers can expect tighter health protocols in these establishments. Let's now talk to Jose Mari del Rosario, head of the Committee on Health Standards for the New Normal at the Philippine Hotel Owners Association. Thank you so much for joining us. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Rain. Nice of you to invite FOA, or Philippine Hotel Owners Association, to join you today.
Well, we appreciate you joining us. What is the current or forecast performance of the hotel industry amid the COVID pandemic and lockdown?
It's very difficult to say, really, Rain, because as you know, there are several types of hotels. There are those that cater to business as well as those that cater to leisure. So the ones that, in both cases, we are really wiped out in the sense that we are looking at 2020 as a lost year for us. And when we can reopen, we don't know, in the sense that we are really very dependent on the guidelines issued by government. So in terms of performance, I forecast performance anywhere from 50% down or even zero occupancy in some of the hotels moving forward.
Well, hotel players have already sought help from the government amid the severe business trauma you're forced to absorb with the pandemic. What has been the response from government, perhaps in terms of tax relief or labor force assistance and travel stimulus?
We have consolidated our requests through the Department of Tourism, and they have responded quite well. And however, we all know that the Department of Tourism does not really have the standards or the powers to enforce, for example, tax relief or breaks in or moratorium in loans or tax or interest relief. So what DOT has done was endorse this to the various departments in government like DOF and Banco Central and BIR for their consideration. So we will really have to await their individual response, and that has been something that I guess will be part of the comprehensive aid that the government will give to all the businesses, including tourism. However, we are encouraged that the government recognizes that the hotel and the tourism industry will be severely hit, and that they know also that the hospitality and the tourism industry has a big multiplier effect in giving jobs to the Filipinos in general, all the way down to the countryside.
Well, how have the hotels adhered to the quarantine guidelines and government mandate and tried to cope with the lockdown? We know that some hotels have resorted to taking in frontliners, essential workers, and BPO employees. But like you said earlier, does this mean occupancy rate was at least not zero?
Yes. We have been allowed to operate under very limited service. For example, no restaurants are allowed to open. And these are mainly catering to BPOs and some to returning OFWs or foreigners transiting out of the country. So that's the main market. Or let's say industrial locators in industrial parks geared for export market. Those have been allowed to open. But going back, as I said, under very limited circumstances, like we can clean the rooms only once a week, we can only accommodate single, at most double occupancy per room. And the cleaning standards have been quite tough in the sense that we have been told to limit, for example, cleaning the rooms once a week, as I said. So things like those.
Well, the Department of Tourism also plans to regulate hotel food deliveries since bars are still not allowed to operate. What kind of coordination are you required to make with government under this guideline? I understand you. There's some record keeping involved.
Oh, yes. We submit weekly statistics to the Department of Tourism on the individual names of guests, how long they're staying, where are they working, and also the staff that are staying in the hotels that are allowed to service the guests that we have. A skeletal force, if I may emphasize.
Did you have to set up the hotels for the new normal? Once quarantine is lifted, what international best practices in the hotel industry would be required in this kind of pandemic environment?
Yes, the Philippine Hotel Owners Association, in cooperation with the DOT and the professional organizations within the hotel industry, like the Executive Housekeepers Association, the Hotel and Restaurant Association of the Philippines, and others, have been coming up with a working paper on strict guidelines on what to do, how to treat the employees as well as guests. So this include strict standards on what they have to wear, how they sanitation standards in cleaning the rooms, public areas, spacing in elevators, things like those. It's a quite a comprehensive document, maybe about 11 or so pages. And what the DOT has done was compile everything and have been able to get the feedback from the industry associations that I mentioned earlier. So there's an ongoing dialogue, and we feel that we in the hotel industry will be very much prepared when we are allowed to open.
Now, what does it mean for the guests in terms of additional safety screenings and health precautions? Do all these precautions cost more for the hotels and therefore it's also passed on to the guests?
Not necessarily. In the hotels, we are a multi-skilled bunch of professionals. So any additional task that is given, we know is for the welfare of the guests as well as the staff. So what we are trying to do is inform all our incoming guests that this will be the new standard. So in case of preparing paperwork, where have you been? Have you been in touch with COVID positive relatives or guests? Have you been to this or that country? We can all send that out in advance to the incoming guests. Now, for those what we call as walk-ins, you appear in the hotel desk and wanting to have a room, you may be required to fill in some paperwork, but not more than what the airlines are currently doing. So as much as possible, we'll streamline what we have to ask. The important thing is to be able to get in touch with them, such as, I guess that's what contact tracing is all about, to be able to find out if and when there is such a positive case in the hotel. But as much as possible, we won't even take in guests that register 37.7 degrees in terms of their body temperature.
Right. Mr. De Rosario, players in the hotel and hospitality industry are currently doing a survey on domestic travel sentiment up to May 22nd. What do you hope to achieve with this survey? And do you think that domestic travel is going to be the solution to the woes of the industry for now? How long before you think the industry might be able to recover?
As I said earlier, we've largely written off 2020, and we are just on a survival mode. We are taking care of our people as much as possible. We don't like layoffs, so we are keeping a skeletal force. But to go back to your earlier question on the survey, we would just like to feel the sentiment of our countrymen about traveling, whether it's international or domestic. Going further into what the prospects are, we feel that the domestic travelers will be the short-term market that we can entice to come in and visit our properties and go see the countryside and whatever it's for staycation. But that is not good for the long haul. It is not sufficient. It is not enough. However, even if an area is considered GCQ, modified ECQ, or whatever, that is not the key determining factor of when we can be feasible to be sustainable. Important thing for us, for example, if you have a location in Boracay or in Puerto Princesa, it's the lifting of the airport restrictions that's important. Even if the airport is open, however, there are no commercial flights coming in, it is useless to open your properties, useless to open the hotel or resorts if no flights are coming in. But even if flights are coming in, if new tourists are required to have a 14-day quarantine, that's the end of his actual vacation, 14 days staying in the hotel. So confined. So it'll be very difficult, Ray.
Well, hopefully the COVID crisis is contained the soonest possible time the flights resume and the hotel and hospitality industry get back on their feet. Thank you so much for joining us and sharing with us your experiences. Jose Mari del Rosario, head of the Committee on Health Standards for the New Normal at the Philippine Hotel Owners Association. We appreciate you being with us. Thank you.